period, the so-called Dark Ages, the one organisation that still functioned internationally, still travelled the Roman roads when nobody else would, handling the king's local and foreign affairs because its members could still read and write, was the church. It had a fully operational network of communications from bishop to bishop throughout Europe, and that's what held things together. The church then was like our telecommunications now. And so the knowledge that the monks had accumulated gradually spread. Knowledge like how Barbagel had worked with the great water wheel and the gearing system that made it so efficient. And in the end, by the Middle Ages, look what they did with that wheel. Here's the wheel being operated by water, and here's the gearing system turning the horizontal movement vertical, then horizontal again, and then vertical again in order to operate the millstones. Here's another system operating a trip hammer for bashing things like mineral ore or cloth or leather, soften it up. Here's a system that operates a similar trip hammer device, but it's to work a suction pump for a water supply. Same system again, operating two levers, pressing on bellows for a blast furnace. And finally over here, a crank that turns a circular movement into back and forward movement for a sawmill. Beautiful system. So, put yourself in their position. The wars are all over. There's loads of productive land everywhere. You've got water coming out of your ears and an amazing machine to use to harness the power. What would you do? Yes, you'd have yourself a medieval industrial revolution.